Estuaries are nearshore marine ecosystems. One type of estuary is a mangrove forest. Mangrove forests are made up of mangrove plants, which have a cage-like root structure and are adapted to live in brackish water and soft soil and a constantly changing water level. These forests are often found on the shorelines of tropical and subtropical regions. To cope with their salty environment, red mangroves filter out salt as water enters, and any salt that does get through is transferred to old leaves and then shed. Black mangroves accomplish the same by filtering out around 90% of the salt as it absorbs water, and excreting the rest through its leaves. Because of the structure of the roots, mangroves protect a biodiverse ecosystem and serve as a nursery for many organisms in the earlier stages of their lives. So here's a few creatures that can be found in a mangrove ecosystem. This upside-down jelly uses its tentacles to filter nutrients and plankton from the water and has these things, which photosynthesize to make additional food for the jelly. The copperband butterfly fish are speedy fish that eat small crustaceans, worms, and coral polyps. These also benefit their ecosystem by feeding on harmful parasites. The double-lined fusiliere eats the small crustaceans that live in the silty layer on the floor of a mangrove forest. Tube anemones attach themselves to the substrate by secreting a hard mucus tube. These anemones have two rings of tentacles, the outer ring for defending themselves and capturing prey, and the inner ring for pulling their food into their mouth. Mangroves are also home to Clark's anemone fish, the Papuan toby, the pajama cardinal fish, ternite chromis, and black bar chromis, along with a variety of reptiles, birds, and mammals. Mangroves also have a symbiotic relationship with coral reefs, which are another important nearshore ecosystem. Mangroves trap muddy sediments, preventing them from reaching coral reefs. This also allows for seagrass to grow and prevents coastal erosion. These sediments would otherwise cover the coral reefs, blocking them from sunlight. Coral reefs, in turn, diffuse wave surges that could be harmful to mangroves. Mangroves also help humans quite a bit. They serve as a carbon sink, absorbing much of the carbon dioxide emitted by humans and their developments, and slowing climate change. Mangroves buffer waves and lessen their blow on any nearby civilization. Mangroves are a large part of the fishing economy wherever they occur. Around 80% of all edible fish grow up in mangrove roots. Humanity, in turn, has participated in the destruction of 20% of mangrove forests since 1980. People have seen mangroves as an easy source of firewood or as an opportunity for farming space and cleared out entire forests, releasing its absorbed carbon dioxide back into the atmosphere. Mangroves are also threatened by coastal developments, oil spills, and runoff from inland pollution. Some individuals and organizations, however, have taken notice of the impact of this destruction. Mangroves for the Future, in India, for example, gathers volunteers from the regions most affected by mangroves and assigns them to raise and plant mangrove trees by hand in order to reconstitute the ecosystems. This also benefits the economy in the villages, since people can earn a living by raising and selling mangrove saplings to the forest department, in addition to all the seafood they will be able to harvest and sell once the forest is started up again. Many of these same people once carelessly demolished mangrove forests, but they have since been educated on the ecosystems that depend on mangroves, including their own village. If you don't live near a mangrove, though, you can still help. Know your elected representative's stance of coastal development and vote with the environment in mind. Do your research on brands before consuming their products. Support local conservation organizations by donating or becoming a member. Educate yourself and those around you. Links to sources we used are in the description. Goodbye.